Hi everyone, today I'm going to present a tutorial about checking the overall validity and quality of a volume mesh using STAR-CCM Plus. Here I'm going to use the mesh generated in the tutorial about CFD simulation of a wind turbine using STAR-CCM Plus, which I have presented in a video in my channel entitled Tutorial CFD Simulation of a Wind Turbine STAR-CCM Plus. You can access this video by using the link given in the description of this video. Generally, a poor quality volume mesh can result in a significant reduction in accuracy and efficiency of the obtained CFD results. STAR-CCM Plus has provided us with the ability to check the validity of the mesh and getting statistics on the mesh quality. In this regard, STAR-CCM Plus evaluates these parameters to measure the validity and quality of mesh. Cell skewness angle, face validity metric, cell quality metric, volume change metric, Chevron quality indicator. In the following sections, we are going to see how each of these parameters is defined, and also we're going to learn how we can use these parameters to evaluate the validity and quality of mesh. Skewness angle. The cell skewness angle is a proper indicator of the mesh quality and suitability. To understand this parameter, consider the following two-dimensional representation of two adjacent cells which are separated by a mutual face. The skewness angle theta is the angle between the face area vector, i.e. face normal, which is here represented by A, and the vector connecting the two cell centroids. Therefore, it can be easily concluded that the angle equal to zero is the best, which indicates that the mesh is orthogonal. In order to reduce the influence of the skewness angle on the results, it is recommended to keep it under 85 degrees. To evaluate the cell skewness angle, right click on Plots, New Plot, select Histogram Plot, click on Histogram Plot 1 and set the parts to Regions. Under axis type, click on bin and set the field function to skewness angle. Here in this plot, we can see the number of cells with a specific skewness angle for all the boundaries in the computational domain. As can be seen, most of the cells have a skewness angle smaller than 2 degrees. To visualize the maximum skewness angle encountered in the computational domain, click on Zoom selected plot option here. Zoom in on this area of the graph. As we can see here, the maximum skewness angle is smaller than 85 degrees, which is acceptable for a CFD simulation. Face validity metric. The face validity metric is a measure of correctness of the face normals relative to cell centroid to which they are attached. As you can observe in these figures, in a good quality cell, the face normals are pointing outwards with respect to the cell centroid, while in a cell of bad face validity, one or more face normals are pointing toward the cell centroid. A face validity of 1 is an indication of a good quality cell, and however, the values smaller than 0.5 indicate the negative volume mesh and must be avoided. To evaluate the face validity, right click on Plots, New Plot, select Histogram Plot, click on Histogram Plot 2 and set the parts to Regions. Under axis type, click on bin and set the field function to face validity. As we can see here, all the cells in the computational domain have a face validity equal to 1, which shows that all face normals are correctly pointing away from the cell centroid. Cell quality metric. In the cell quality metric, generally flat cells with highly non-orthogonal faces have a low cell quality. As an example, these figures show a good quality cell and a bad quality cell. A cell with a quality of 1 is considered perfect. A cubic cell is an example of such a perfect cell. However, a cell with poor quality has a cell quality approaching 0. Cells with a quality less than 10 to the power of minus 5 are considered bad. To evaluate the cell quality metric, right-click on Plots, New Plot, select Histogram Plot. Click on Histogram Plot 3 and set the parts to Regions. Under Axis Type, click on Bin and set the Field Function to Cell Quality. To visualize the minimum cell quality encountered in the computational domain, click on Zoom Selected Plot option here. Zoom in on this area of the graph. As we can see here, the minimum cell quality is about 0.02, which is acceptable for a CFD simulation. Volume change metric. The volume change metric evaluates the ratio of the volume of a cell to the largest volume of its neighboring cells. These figures show a good volume change and a bad volume change. Notice that the sharp variations of the cell volumes in the vicinity of a cell can cause serious inaccuracies and instabilities. Cells with poor quality are those with a volume change of 0.01 or even less. To evaluate the volume change metric, right-click on Plots, New Plot, select Histogram Plot. Click on Histogram Plot 4 and set the parts to Regions. Under Axis Type, click on Bin and set the Field Function to Volume Change. To visualize the minimum volume change encountered in the computational domain, click on Zoom Selected Plot option here. Zoom in on this area of the graph. As we can see here, the minimum volume change is about 0.02, which is acceptable for a CFD simulation. Chevron quality indicator associates a value of 1 to cells in which the line joining the cell centers does not pass through the common face. These cells are considered as bad cells. Note that a value of 0 is attributed to every other cell. For instance, these figures show a normal cell and a chevron cell. Note that the chevron cells affect the accuracy and robustness in the calculation of the convective fluxes. To identify the chevron cells, right-click on Plots, New Plot, select Histogram Plot, click on Histogram Plot 5 and set the parts to Regions. Under Axis Type, click on Bin and set the Field Function to Chevron Quality Indicator. As we can see here, all the cells in the computational domain have a chevron quality indicator equal to 0, which shows that there is no chevron cells in the computational domain. Locating cells of poor quality. To locate the cells with bad quality, we can create thresholds based on the parameters presented in the previous sections. For this purpose, first create a new geometry scene. Under Geometry Scene 2, Displayers, Geometry 1, click on Parts. In the Properties window, deselect all the boundaries except for the boundaries of the NREL Phase 6 wind turbine. click on outline 1 and uncheck outline. Use the rotate view and zoom bottom. To put the wind turbine geometry in this position. To create a threshold, right click on the drive parts and new part, threshold. Set the input parts to virtual rotating subdomain, click OK. Set the scalar to skewness angle. Click on query to see the scalar range. Set the minimum value to 30. Finally, set the display to existing displayer geometry 1. Click on create and then close the dialog. Here we can see the cells with the skewness angle values between 30 and 85. Note that the new threshold node has been created here in the properties window. We can change the range of the skewness angle. You can rotate, translate, and zoom the display in order to investigate the location of the poor quality cells. The same procedure can be applied to visualize the location of the poor quality cells using other metrics presented earlier. Removing invalid cells. STAR-CCM Plus has the capability to identify and remove the poor quality cells after the mesh generation process. Up to 6 different mesh criteria can be used when choosing which cells to remove. The 6 criteria are shown here. Minimum face validity, minimum cell quality, minimum volume change, minimum contiguous cells, minimum connected face area, negative volume cells. The removed cells are moved into a separate region and they are not used in the CFD analysis. STAR-CCM Plus, by adding symmetry plane boundaries to the neighboring cell faces of cells that have been removed, minimizes the effect of these removed areas on the solution. To remove the invalid cells, create a new mesh scene and open it in the graphics window. Under regions, right click on the virtual rotating subdomain and select remove invalid cells. Here you can specify the desired threshold values for each criterion, as we can see here. You can change these default values to change the metric values. Also, to restore the default values, click reset. For instance, let's set the cell quality to 0.03 and then click Identify. As can be seen, 1806 cells whose cell quality metric is smaller than 0.03 have been identified. Note that if we set all these values to their default values, no invalid cell can be identified, which is an indication of the reasonable quality of the mesh. However, note that the best method to take care of invalid cells or in general any mesh quality issues is first locating these cells in the computational domain and then applying proper volume or surface mesh refinements to these regions. this is the end of this video. I hope you found this video useful. Please let me know what you think about this video by leaving a comment in the comment section. Thank you for watching the video, and for further upcoming videos, please subscribe to this channel.